Hi everyone! People ask me quite often what I use to reinforce the fins in my tails. And so right now I'm going to show you sort of the basic process for that. The materials you're going to need, this main one is this clear plastic canvas mesh. It's often used as backing in cross stitching. You can get it at craft stores like Joann Fabrics. Going to want a Sharpie. That's what you're going to trace with. Same with scissors. Some double fold bias tape. The color doesn't really matter. If you go with a lighter color, you won't have to worry about it showing through your tail when it's wet or any dye leaking and staining your tail. And some sort of flexible foam cell material. These are just scrap materials that I have gotten with packaging. This one is kind of thin. This one significantly thicker. You can probably do the same thing with craft foam if you want, but I'm just using what I have on hand. And so I'm going to use these materials to basically go inside the fins and fill out these areas between the seams of the existing boning that's already in the fins. This is the Finfolk and Merbella collab Ailea tail, or Ailea. And there's a piece of boning at the top and one in the middle here. And then the rest is loose fabric. So what I'm gonna do for each of the side fins and the calf fins is I'll go in and open up. There we go. I'll go in and open up the side seam where the fin attaches. You can see there's it's a little thicker with the doubling of the material. So I'll seam rip that open, not down the whole thing, just in that first section and that second section, so that there's a little gap I can slide my material through and get it right in there. And I'll use the canvas mesh for the side fins, and I'll use that flexible foam material for the dorsal. And what that's going to do is, because these have tiny little air pockets in them, they float. So that'll make the dorsal sort of float upwards in the water a little better, but it'll still be soft and flexible enough that it won't be uncomfortable to sit on. So I can't wait to show you how this works out. I'll try to take some progress videos on the way, and let's get started. So the first thing I'm going to do, this is just a little scrap material, but you can use your full sheet if you have it. I've just already cut a bunch of pieces out from earlier projects, so I want to reuse them. So I'm going to look for the seam on the inside of the boning. And now everything I want to do, I want it to fit in between these two seams, which means I'm going to cut this a little smaller, small enough that even when I've lined the edges of it with that bias tape, it still won't stretch out the fin, because I just want it to fill the space. I don't want it to stretch it and stress that material, even though it is stretchy and it has some give to it. I just want to fill it. So I'm going to take the side that is already sort of has this smooth edge to it and line it up with that long seam there. So I know I'm going to have this one on this side, and then I'll take the Sharpie and just go around, and you can see right here it stops lining up and it curves inward. So I'll trace to there, trace this little give, and then I'll go up this side. And I'm not concerned with filling out to the very end of these little things. I just want to get sort of the general shape filled in the middle. Because this boning continues all the way down to the tip, I don't need to go into the smaller part that's on this side of it. So I'll probably end this insert right about here. Really what you want to do is just take the thin part that's at the widest point and make sure your support is going all the way down that. And that way when you're swimming, the fin can't crumple on itself as you go. And that'll help make it look fuller in the water and get that beautiful shape really visible.
All right, here I've got my pieces all cut out. You can see they don't need to be perfect. They just need to be kind of close enough. I've got that mesh for the fins and the foam for the dorsal. Again, I let the seams that exist be my guide with pieces, or added little breaks where I thought they'd need them. For the side fins, I generally go pretty close to where the tail meets the body. Not quite all the way there, but pretty close. For the dorsal, I leave a little bit more space because your back is gonna curve as you're moving especially. And because this is giving it flotation more than anything else, you can have that gap at the base and it'll still be pulling that fin upward in the water. It doesn't have to be right against your body, and that'll give you a little bit more room for movement. So here's all my pieces. Next stage is going to go in and take out small sections of seam. And then what I'm also going to do is use the bias tape to coat some of these rough edges on this mesh. Now this is what's called double fold bias tape. That means it's got two little sections each with a fold in them. Usually you take this over fabric and you put this around the hem so you don't have any raw edges showing. I'm actually going to cut this down that very middle crease so that I can use each side of it, because you don't really need a lot. You're just basically taking this and you're gonna wrap each half edge around the edge of the fabric and then use some glue to hold it on. So essentially each edge will look like that. And that'll just make sure that none of these little pointy bits can ever catch and pull on the fabric. All right, so your next step is going to be turning the tail inside out and then making markings with pencil or fabric pen where the seams of the fins line up so that you know where to go between them to get the gaps you'll want to slide your materials through. So for example, let me just pull out this fin. You can see here, you want to go between the existing boning and seams. I'm not taking out any of the existing seams this time, though I have done that with other tails like the lionfish. So I'm aiming for right in this gap. I want to take out some of that space without going too far past it either side. And then at the bottom of this fin, I'm also going to take a little chunk out of the middle. Now the inserts, like the craft foam and the material for the side fins. Sorry, I'm at my parents' house now trying to finish this up, so it's a little more hectic. But these are still pretty flexible. Like this is, you know, it's wider than here, but you can roll it up into a little tube to get it in and then flatten it out again. And one of the nice things about this material is that even when you bend it and push, it doesn't permanently crease. So you can bend it back and it goes right back to shape. And that's part of why I like this for material in the side fins, that lack of a permanent crease, as well as it's just neutrally, a little more neutrally buoyant than something like the craft foam, so your fins aren't gonna float up next to you. Now your dorsal fin is probably gonna be the easiest one to start inserting, so I'll demonstrate that first. This seam here is composed, well, all the fin seams have four layers, and there's a serge stitch holding them all together and then additional stitches holding them inside. So the first thing you're gonna wanna do is pick a section. So we'll start with this larger one right here to demonstrate. And you're gonna take a seam ripper or some sharp thread snippers, and you're gonna gently go in between. And now I'm not gonna cut the fabric, I'm just gonna start snipping the thread. And I'm gonna open up probably about a 2-inch section here, just getting that thread out. So once you've got these smaller sections sort of trimmed open,
you'll see that this doesn't actually open anything right away. It lets you get at those different layers though. So because these are, you have a pretty small seam allowance here because the Finfolk team is great seamstresses and they make these nice and small so they won't poke into you as you're swimming. But it does mean you have less to work with if you're modifying things. So I like to just go ahead and it'll focus, preemptively pin each half together so that when I start opening this up, the dorsal fin isn't gonna slide out on its own. It's gonna already be attached at those points. So when I go to re-sew these two together, it'll be a lot easier. Now I'm gonna take my snips and go in at those stitches you can see in the middle there. There's actually gonna be two layers of them. And I'm just gonna go in and open that up until it's really acts like a hole into the dorsal fin. All right, so once I've got my sections trimmed and pinned, I'm going to take this to the sewing machine and I'm gonna sew each individual side together just so that no dorsal fin sections have a chance of slipping out. I'm gonna leave this opening. You can see where I can reach into the dorsal here and sew on each side of it just in here. And here you can see one where I've just sewn the two sides together, but you've got the little pocket. And that's what we're going to be sliding the different parts of the fin supports into, whether it's the side supports or the dorsal supports. But first I'm gonna flip it inside out again and show you what it looks like from the outside. Okay, and here's one last look at all the pieces separately. You can see I've got this bias tape around the edge of the supports for the fins now, so there's no sharp edges that could catch on the fabric. I've got my different sections of the dorsal fin labeled so I remember where they go easier. And even though I've taken apart little bits of the fin, you can't really tell from the outside, and I will be going in and sewing them up again later. So it'll be more secure than it looked on the inside. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take these and I'm gonna flip it inside out again so I can put them into each of their sections and then sew them back up just a little bit. Okay, so all the pieces of the dorsal are now inserted. So I'm just gonna go ahead and sew these back together. Sorry for my really bad stitching on the last part. I'm using my mom's machine and it doesn't like me. But it doesn't matter so much. It's not gonna be visible from the outside. You can even hand sew these and it'll be just fine. So, all right, I'm gonna sew all of these little sections up and then I'll move on to the pectoral fins. All right, before I put in this last fin, I wanna show you the difference between this unmodified fin, which still has two pieces of boning in it. So it's like a little more flexible. You can squish it up a little easier versus the stiffer fin that I've now put in, which has two more sections of support on the inside that holds it out a little stiffer. You can't quite squish it as much, though it does fold along this crease. And then the dorsal too stands up now. And hopefully in the water, this will just sort of float up behind me as I'm swimming, giving a more stiff fish-like effect that I personally prefer in tails. Though there's some people like the floppier fins, I just like the stiffer ones, and this is how I've found works for adding them to the tails. All right, I'm gonna put that last fin in, and hopefully I'll be able to get some video swimming in this to show you how it looks in the water too. All right, so if you've been watching these videos and modifying your tail with me so far, you've seen that I've taken sections of flexible plastic mesh and added them to the side fins and the calf fins. I used craft foam or cell foam in the dorsal fin. And if you are happy with how this looks, you can stop here. So this will be perfectly functional in the water. It'll give you a nice stiffer fin look with a floating dorsal. But there's another thing I like to do that's kind of a finishing element. And that is
make these little guys. This last step is the most finicky, I would say, of what I've done and showed you so far, but it sort of solves the last issue I have with these fin modifications, which is that if you're, you know, swimming and you have, say this carpet is my body and this is the fin, if you swim up in that direction, the fin is going to hinge downward along that seam. And so it'll end up being pressed flat to your body at times, and you have to sort of send it away with your hand again to get it floating nicely in the water. So what this does is form a little pocket that you'll insert into the inside of the tail, right up against the fin, sandwiching the insert between it. And that'll look something like this. And so when this is against your body, it stops the fin from laying flat against your skin or the skin of the tail. And it gives it a little pocket that when you're done moving in that direction, it just rebounds back to center and holds it away from you. I think this is the closest look to having a silicone fin that you can replicate with a fabric tail. Now, this is just my preference. It's not necessary, but I really like the way it looks. I'll show you a video of me standing with one of these inserts in one fin and none in the other, and then I'll show you how to make one yourself if that's something you want to add to your tails as well. So here is the tail without these inserts in it. As you can see, it can fall flat against the body, and if you were swimming, it would just follow gravity or flotation or the pressure of the water and land in one of those spaces. So I'm going to take this slide it in. So here you can see this fin doesn't have that little insert in it versus this fin does. And what it's doing is it's holding that fin out from the body a little bit so that if I was swimming, it wouldn't have that hinge effect flattening it against me. Again, this step isn't necessary. It just depends how you want your fins to perform in the water. I like when they stand out really stiff as though they were silicone, and so this is the approach I've come up with to mimic that. As you can see, both move around just fine, even with this in there. All right, so if you would like to add these elements to your tail and fin modifications, this is how I've done this one. First, you're gonna get just a long rectangle of your scrap fabric or your scrap mesh, and then you're gonna reach inside the tail and find where the pocket is that you put the fin through. So on the dorsal, I sewed these sections together, but on the side hip fins, I left that little pocket. And so I'm gonna figure out how long this is. For mine, it's about 1.5 inches, and where it is in the fin, which for me is right about there. So I'm gonna take this and line it up with where I know that opening is and make sure it goes about 2 inches into the tail or so. Now, because of where I placed the pocket, you'll notice that this runs through the seam. If my pocket was lower down, I could just leave this a rectangle. Because it's up here, instead I'm gonna have to trim it. So I'm gonna take a Sharpie and carefully I'll trace along where the seam lines up with the mesh. Be really careful not to get any Sharpie on your tail. And then you can cut that out to get the angle that you're gonna use. And so when I slide this in, it'll lay right along there. And so for the second step, I'm going to do just that. I'm going to take this and put it inside so that it lines up. And I'll poke it a little. Can't quite see it, but it's right in there. So now to figure out how long that section has to be, I'm going to go inside and see how much of it is sticking out past the seam. See if it'll focus. There we go. So then I'm gonna take this and I'll just bend it right along there so that when I pull it out,
I can count how many cells this goes in each direction, and then use my material to either trace that or count it out to make the final one. This one's too short to be used in this because you want these to generally be longer. Now on this one, I made the ending partition 10 cells long, and I find that that may have been a little short now that I've tried it out in the tail. This is still a work in progress. It's something I'm developing as I use them, and I'm working on improving it. So if you also make any adjustments to this that you feel work particularly well, please let me know how you did it, and I may incorporate it myself. One of the things I really miss about the current state of the mermaid community, I guess, is that kind of collaborative sharing of knowledge, just because the transition from forum-based communication to social media just is less of a good vessel for it. I don't think people are intentionally hiding things. I think it's just there's less long discussions on things like tail making than there used to be. So on this next one, I think I might actually go and double this. So I'll take this and I'll make them twice as long, maybe 20 long. So I'm gonna trace that out right now using this as my template. All right, here's my shapes. I did one that's 20 segments long at the base and one that's 15 because that seemed a little large. And so I'm gonna make them both and see how it goes. Now, as a note, when you're drawing these, always leave at least one cell gap between them, because as you snip them, you're gonna wanna make sure each side has a solid edge. So even though you're cutting them, you can still trim off these little spiky segments on each edge so that it's a little easier to work with and not as likely to snag. Now, once I cut these out, I am going to use some bias tape. You can use either single-sided bias tape cut in half or double-sided bias tape cut in half or quarters around each edge of the top down to where I'm gonna bend it. So that's just this top side down to where I'm gonna fold it at the base. So that'll be this segment on these long ones and just this segment on these short ones. And as for attaching the bias tape, I've just been using hot glue. I think this is the perfect sort of amount of quick drying, works fast, holds as well as it needs to. We're not putting a lot of stress on these. And I think the hot glue also fills in those gaps a little bit and makes the edge smoother and less likely to cause problems inside the tail. You could use something like E6000, but I really think it would be more trouble than it's worth, especially with how long it would take to cure. So that's just what I'll be using for the next step. Here, I just wanted to show you my technique for attaching the bias tape. You're gonna take the end and put just a little bit of hot glue on there. Center it on here, and then pinch each side down, squeezing the hot glue towards the edge. This does get a little bit messy, so I just keep a trash can next to me. Just squeeze it, holding it in place until it's cooled enough to stay where it is. Then you can fold the end down and just lay hot glue down the middle to continue it along the edge. I like to start at the corner and go down to where this end is, and then I'll do a second piece along this side. Now I'm gonna cut it right here, fold it down again, and use a little more to finish it off. And so I'll do this for all of the pieces first. All right, so once you've got the bias tape on, you're gonna wanna take these and fold them along those lines you marked. So this is going to be the length that goes out into the tail. Now match them up so you make sure you're folding them the correct directions. Though this material is very forgiving and you can
adjust later and bend it the opposite direction if you need to. But all right, I've got those ready. And now I'm going to take these sections and glue them. These are some bases I cut out. It's double the length of each bottom. So this one is 40 squares long. This one's 30. And you're going to line up and glue them on like this. Now this first layer of hot glue doesn't have to be perfect. Just a couple lines or points to hold it in place. We're going to firm it up in a minute, but you basically want these, and you'll notice these tend to like try to unbend, and that's part of what's going to hold the fin in shape, is that tendency of them to move. Now you're going to want to make sure that they're really lined up square to square, so there's a tiny little gap at the bottom, and that's what allows, when your fin slides in, it to just click into place all the way at the bottom. And that'll help keep it better. If you push them too far together, they'll push each other away from each other and open up. So you don't want it to do that. You just want them a tiny little bit apart so they lie flush, and to glue those into place. Once you have your sections held together with the glue, you can gently bend the plastic inward a little to give it a slight curve. This is the curve that's going to be against your body, so it makes it a little more comfortable. Next, you're going to cut sections of your double-sided bias tape to the same length as each of the long sides, and then two more for each of the short sides. Go ahead and unfold those so they're a little easier to work with. Now you're going to take one half of each and attach it to the bottom first. So you're going to glue all the way along this edge. It doesn't have to be perfect or particularly neat. You can be pretty liberal, but you don't have to smother the fabric in hot glue. Go ahead and place that on there and press it into place. The fabric will make it more comfortable against your skin, and it'll also provide a better grip for the glue than against the plastic alone. Once you have it attached to the bottom, take your scissors and you'll just snip right here in the middle so that these sides can fold around that upward section on the top. And go ahead and glue those down too. Now it's not the prettiest in the world, but at this point it's functional. I also add the caps to the end just to make it a little prettier, but that's basically it. All right, and here's my finished pieces. They just slide into whichever side of the tail I want to try them out in. If I end up having a clear preference about what length or style I like best, I'll add it to the video or put it in the caption depending on when I post this and when I get a chance to swim next. But if you try this out, please let me know, tag me, send me a video of you swimming, or let me know what your experience is. I would love to know what other people think of this or any improvements you might make. All right, so I was able to get some footage underwater of this tail with my modifications, thanks to Mermaid Mishy and Mermaid Emily. Here you can see these stiffer pectoral and calf fins and how they stand out for my body better. You can also see the floating dorsal effect. I do think that the dorsal still has a tendency to fall to one side if I'm swimming fast, but it's great for posing for photos. I've also included a few minutes of video of me swimming in the modified tail with the Windy City Merfolk Pod in Chicago, who kindly let me join them. Thank you, Mermaid Emily, Mermaid Spooky, and Mermaid Mishy, who is visiting from Florida.
You can check the text box to visit and follow their social media pages. Feel free to leave a comment if you have any questions about my fin modification process, and happy crafting! Thanks for watching. I'll be a mermaid, caught on your rod, coming for your aid. Isn't it odd? Isn't it silly? Now that you know, someone this slippery can't let you go. It's true. You know that I would jump too. You know that I would jump too. Ooh, into the blue. You should have left me caught up the rope. I'm too much sugar. I am your dope. Glue. Hold your breath.